Welcome to my workshop, where safety is the number one priority. It's kind of a gloomy day outside, a little bit rainy, stormy, lots of clouds. Not really a good day for going out driving anywhere, but it is time for some maintenance. So I thought, this is a good chance to go ahead and take care of all the maintenance on the daily driver here, the trusty steed. So today I'm going to be going through some of the routine maintenance stuff you do to a Model A Ford, including oil change. We're going to do lube and all the things you check just periodically. About every 500 miles is a good time to check and lube. This car has an oil filter in it, so it doesn't need the oil change every 500 miles. It goes 2,000, 3,000 miles between oil changes, and oil doesn't look too bad. So this has about 2,500 on the oil, I think. But the lube is almost due. It's not quite 500 miles since the last lube, but it's okay to go ahead and do it anyway. No such thing as over-lubing a Model A, so let's go ahead and get started on this. Since this car is my daily driver, it doesn't really get babied as much as that car does, which is kind of a show car. That car gets cleaned underneath, topside, in and out. It's always spotless, even the chassis and everything. This car, since I put so many miles on it, I do wash it every now and then. I clean underneath, but not as often as I do that car. And since this car is all original and rarely leaves the shop, this car gets cleaned a couple times a year, but it doesn't really need to get cleaned a lot because it doesn't really go anywhere. But that car is spotless inside and out. This car, so this car isn't really a show car, but I do try to take care of it. And the oil, it's not that dirty. It looks pretty decent, but it's about as dirty as I ever want to get it. It's time to change it anyway. We're going to go ahead and do that today. We'll start by draining the oil. This part's pretty self-explanatory. Let's get a big crescent wrench on here. This is my metric crescent wrench. Trick is to keep your hands out of it. No matter what, you're going to get oil on you, so have a rag ready. And there goes all the lifeblood out of the Model A. And while you're waiting for the oil to drain, just take your rag and just kind of wipe around down here and kind of clean everything off. You can see since this car is a daily driver, it doesn't really get detailed underneath. It's just kind of gets wiped down every now and then. Sometimes if you go stand on the passenger side running board before you do this, it helps the oil move over to the passenger side of the car and helps drain more thoroughly. Some people actually drill small holes in the bottom of the dipper trays. That's a bad idea. They say, oh, it gives you a complete oil change. Yeah, it also gives you dry bearings every time you start the car. It's really dumb. Don't do that. If someone tells you to do that, they're not a Model A expert. All right. Replace the drain plug, also known as the bung, by the way. As tight as you need right there. And take your pan of used oil out, put that in the big barrel out back, and then that'll become recycled oil. All right, I just checked the maintenance logs, and actually it's not quite due, but it's almost due. About every 5,000 miles, or when it starts to look a little discolored, you want to change your transmission fluid. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now, even though it's not quite due, but it's getting kind of close, and it is starting to show a little bit of color. Not bad. That's still too tight to do by hand. I just hate when this falls into the tub and you have to retrieve it. There we go. See, that's not too bad, but it's a little bit darker than brand new, but not much. As you can tell, the back of my glove ripped on the wishbone here, so I'll be swapping this glove out as well. Now it's time to pull the oil filter. As you can see, I write the mileage on my filters. Since I usually don't put them on more than a little over hand tight, it's usually not too much of a problem to get them off. Now the trick is to use, I use a Motorcraft FL1 oil filter, but if you can find the ones that don't have the little rubber valve in them, the one-way valve, if you can find those, get those are the best ones. There's our old filter, and there's the new one. And yes, I paint my filters the engine color just because it looks better looking through the louvers. Everybody knows how to replace an oil filter, right? Just in case you don't, what you're supposed to do is get a little bit of the old oil, put it on the rubber part here. I almost don't have enough oil to do that with here. Okay. And thread it on. Now, not all Model A's have oil filters. They didn't come from the factory with an oil filter. Some of them have this type on the timing gear cover. Some of them have them coming off the side of the valve cover. It just depends on which kit you have. I just put my filters on about that tight. And that's it. Now take a Sharpie and write the mileage. I do this even on my modern cars. Now it's time to add oil back to the engine. Model A typically will take somewhere between 4 and 5 quarts. I use Mobil 1 high mileage 10W30. You can use whatever you want, really. There's this big debate about what oil to put in a Model A. The truth is, the very worst oil made today is still better than the best oil made when this car was new. So don't lose a lot of sleep over it. I just buy this oil when it goes on sale. Keep it in the shop. Likes to burp and get on the fenders. Pour it in a little slower, I guess. Now keep in mind that as soon as you start the motor, if you have an oil filter, about half a quart is going to go into that oil filter. So what I like to do is I fill mine where it's just a little bit. It's not quite there yet. I fill mine to where it's almost right on the full mark. Then after starting the car, then the oil filter fills up. Then it usually ends up just a little bit below the full mark, which is right where I want it. See what the, it's just about there. See that? A little bit more. I'll just let it kind of simmer here. That should take it right to the full mark. Oh yeah, there we go. Right on. Oil's pretty clean, you can't really see, but it's right on F. While you've got this side of the hood open, it's a good idea to check the steering fluid. Even though a Model A doesn't have power steering, it still takes steering fluid. Some Model A's, people have installed a grease fitting on the steering box here. That is wrong. You do not put grease in there. You put oil, heavy oil. I use this product called Hyperlube, if you can see that. It's a lot thicker than that supposed 600W lubricant that the Model A suppliers sell. It's really thick and gooey, probably closer to what was actually in the steering box and the rear end when this car was new. But if you use a good thick oil in here, not grease, then your steering will be much smoother and easier. Now the
that it's time to refill the transmission. Get this plug out right here. We shouldn't put it in as tight as I had it. The best way I found for putting in the transmission fluid is to use a squeezy bottle. So I have a squeezy bottle here, and I just fill it up with as much fluid as I need and what I need. In this particular case, the transmission uses about 24 ounces of gear oil. So I'll just put it right here. I know you didn't get to see that, I'm sorry. But what I do is I just put my finger over the end of the bottle here and then just kind of guide it in. And now just start squeezing. The trick is to fill this up until it's just about right at the fill mark. So keep your rag handy in case you overfill it. You'll have to clean up the mess if you do. That's a sign that it's not full. There it is. Oops, I hit the camera again. Sorry about that, guys. All right, yeah, it's definitely full now. So I got a mess to clean up here. Enough. Kind of wipe down and we're good. Checking the rear end fluid is very easy to do. Take a 3/8 inch drive socket and just go into the plug here. As you can see, I've not painted my plugs. I left the natural finish. This rear end just got rebuilt about 5,000 miles ago, so my guess is the fluid's still fine, but we're just going to check the level, and it's fine. If you need to top off your rear end, use the same squeezy bottle you use for the transmission, and just insert fluid until it starts to drip out. Look at the case, it's already pretty full. I was just demonstrating for you, sacrificing my shop floor for you. Thing left to do is check the coolant. And as you can see, there it is. This car typically runs the coolant level just above the baffle. All Model A's are a little different. Some of them they'll run just a little below the baffle, but this one's almost always right at about that high above the baffle. It never really loses water. It's always been well behaved. So that's it for checking and changing the fluids in your Model A Ford. The next time we're going to get out our grease gun and we're going to lube the chassis, lube the distributor, and lube all the connecting points of the car, the brake rods, all that stuff. That'll be in the next video. But for this one, the only thing left to do is the cold start and take it for a drive.